In this video, we will discuss how to calculate the full width at half maximum using Origin. We know that the FWHM is required from the XRD data to calculate the crystallite size by using the Scherer equation. And in this equation, here all other parameters are available except the beta, which is the full width at half maximum in radian. So we will calculate in this video how we can use Origin to calculate FWHM. Let's start with our data, which is of the pure LIF. This is the XRD data, which is in two columns. This is the two theta values and the intensity of the XRD. So here we will start Origin. Here is our book one. So I will import the data here and I do a direct drag and drop here. So the data will come here. Now I will plot this data. And the data is here. I will have to correct the legends because the two legends are extra here. And now this is the data. I will have to only focus on the data, so I will zoom this portion in order to have a good view of it. And as we know, in order to find the crystallite size, the FWHM we calculate from the maximum intensity peak. So I will focus on this one, and let's say I do select this peak only, and here it is. Let me maximize it a bit more, and here is our peak. Now our plot is ready to be fitted, and I do some arrangement here that drag it here, and now I go to the analysis, fitting, and the nonlinear fit, and I open the dialog box, and here it is. So we are having, this is the common dialog box for the origin functions, and here I select the Gaussian, which is here. So let's move it here. Now this is one iteration. I apply it for a couple of time in order to see the how the fitting proceeds, and then finally I will click this fit until converge, and it is done here. So now I will press OK, and as I see that it has generated two data sheets here and one over here. As this one is not required, so let me delete this one and go to the fit NL1 sheet, and here all the information is given, and this is giving me the values of the plot. So I will take the full width at half maximum from here, which is 0.23694, but note that this is given in degrees. So I will have to convert this into radian before using for calculation of the crystallite size. Thank you for watching the video.